باسم الاب والابن والروح القدس الاله الواحد امين. In the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today, we are celebrating a great feast. We call this feast the entry of our Lord Jesus Christ into Jerusalem. Maybe to some people, it's just another holiday. To some people, it's to look good for that day. To some people, it's to make fasting food so we can get together and wish one another happy Palm Sunday. But brothers and sisters, this is not about how you look like. This is not about what you're going to dress today to impress yourself and impress the others. This is not about only having a lunch or dinner together as one family. Today, brothers and sisters, we prepare ourselves for a seven-day journey. Because today is Palm Sunday. Even though in the church we don't call it Palm Sunday, we call it the entry of our Lord Jesus Christ into Jerusalem. The reason they call it Palm Sunday because the kids and the people were holding palm leaves and olive leaves, welcoming the Lord Jesus into Jerusalem. And we decorate the church with palm leaves. And we dress with a green color so we could remember what happened 2,000 years ago when the Lord Jesus entered the city of Jerusalem. Brothers and sisters, the great fast, the 40-day fast, has ended yesterday. Now we go into another fast, extra fast, the Holy Week fast, and we fast from the food as we have been fasting for the last 40 days. From March 15 all the way till yesterday when we celebrated the feast and the resurrection of Saint Lazarus. That's why it's called 50 days, and some they call it 40 days. It's 40 days up to yesterday, and one more week becomes 50 days. Brothers and sisters, it's a great joy. What a great joy to be here today and every Sunday celebrating this great feast. Celebrating the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, indeed. It is a victory. He came for this reason. الرب يسوع المسيح أتى لكي يدخل إلى مدينة أورشليم. الرب يسوع المسيح أتى لكي يستعد أن يدخل طوعيا إلى آلامه في هذا الأسبوع العظيم. لأسباب نحن بالكنيسة وبكل مصطلحاتنا نقول آلام طوعية، يعني ما حدا جبره أن يدخل في هذه الآلام. طوعية من عنده. طوعية لأنه حبنا. أهل ترى نحن اليوم بعد مرور 2000 سنة لساتنا نحب للمسيح. محبة حقيقية من القلب. محبة تفرجي العالم نور المسيح بحياتنا؟ هل يا ترى ما زلنا بنحب المسيح إذا العالم شافونا بالشوارع بيعرفوا أن نحن أولاد المسيح؟ هل يا ترى لساتنا نحن بنحب المسيح مشان كل إنسان نلتقى معه في أي مكان ما يعرف من طريقة حديثنا أنه نحن أولاد المسيح؟ هل يا ترى نحن من لساتنا بنحب المسيح مشان وين ما نكون في أي بقعة من بقع هذا العالم العالم يعرف ويقول هدول الجماعة من أتباع المسيح؟ هيدي هي المسيحية الحقيقية، أن نكون مسيحيين ونفس الوقت أن نعيش في هذا العالم، أن نكون مسيحيين ونتعامل مع كل الناس اللي بيحبونا واللي بيبغضونا كمان، أن نكون مسيحيين ويرى هذا العالم وجه المسيح في كل واحد من هذا الشعب المسيحي الذي أخذ سر المعمودية واعتمد ومسح بسر الزيت وسر الميرون لنكون شهودا للمسيح في هذا العالم. Brothers and sisters, in the book of the Old Testament, there's a beautiful verse from the book of Prophet Zechariah. From Prophet Zechariah, chapter 9, verse 9. Prophet Zechariah came almost 600 years before Christ. He came 600 years before Christ. And not only Prophet Zechariah, Prophet Isaiah, and many prophets, they prophesied the coming of Christ, and they prophesied what happened today. On Palm Sunday, the day of the entry of the Lord Jesus Christ into Jerusalem. Our Lord Jesus Christ, He's alive yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Our Lord Jesus Christ came to save all of us. This is why we say, Hosanna. Repeat after me, Hosanna.
Hosanna.
Because the word Hosanna means save us. This is why we say every Sunday, every liturgy we say, Hosanna. Repeat after me, Hosanna.
Hosanna.
We ask the Lord Jesus to save us. Let me read to you, brothers and sisters, what Prophet Zechariah said. From today, 2,600 years ago, 600 years before Christ, he said, repeat after me, rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion, shout, O daughter of Jerusalem,
behold,
thy king
coming to you.
He is just
and a victorious Lord
and a humble
Savior.
Prophet Zechariah said this 2,600 years ago. Rejoice, O daughter of Zion. Zion. Sahyaon. Do you know what Zion stands for? The word Zion. The daughter of Zion. Zion means those who keep the commandment of God. Repeat after me. Zion means
those
who keep
the commandment
of God. You could be also the daughter and the son of Zion. Zion is not for the Jews. Zion is not for the people who live in Israel. Zion is for every followers of Christ, because Zion means I keep the commandment of God. That's what Zion's for. But today, unfortunately, politics have stole the word Zion, and there's a group of people they call Zionists, but they have nothing to do with keeping the commandment of our Lord and Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. Sometimes we are afraid to say, I am a Zionist. Because you can't say this today because they will consider you a bad person. Brothers and sisters, those words were before Zionists came and made organizations in Jerusalem or in the world. These words, it comes from the Bible itself. That's why we as a church, we say it and repeat it. O daughter of Zion. O daughter of Jerusalem. The mountain of Zion and the mountain of Jerusalem are rejoicing today to welcome the Lord Jesus Christ into the city of Jerusalem. Yes, he is just. Repeat after me. Yes.
He is.
Just. Repeat after me. Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Victorious.
Lord.
Repeat after me.
Yes, he is.
A humble. Savior. Why he is just? Because he gives you a chance. No matter what you do. Repeat after me.
He is just.
Because
he gives me a chance
every day. He is victorious. You know why he is victorious, God? Because he has victory over the dead. You will live forever if you believe in Christ. You will live forever if you believe in Christ. And only if you believe in Christ, you can live forever. Repeat after me. I can live forever.
If I believe
in the Lord Jesus,
Christ.
He's the only one that can save you. No one can else give you a chance to live forever. He's a humble Savior. Yes, he is. He sat on a donkey. He sat on a donkey when he entered the city of Jerusalem. Are we also humble today like our Savior? Sometimes we go out of our way and we borrow money to buy a nice car so I can show off my car in front of my friends. Sometimes you go out of your way and you become in so much debt because you want to buy something you cannot afford. Sometimes you want to buy a house or clothes or go on vacation just because your friends went on vacation. You can only do so much. Don't overdo it. You'll go bankrupt. And you're going to gamble, bankrupt. And you won't be good for the rest of your life. Be humble like the Lord Jesus. He was humble. He could have sat on a horse. But he sat on a donkey. Because a donkey shows the humility of our Savior. But he is the king. But he is on a donkey. Just like a poor man has donkeys to go to the field. Everyone can afford a donkey. But not everyone can afford horses and camels. Brothers and sisters, I want to wish all of you today blessed feast. I look forward to see you this week during the Holy Week. Because this week we're going to have services every night. Monday night, 7 p.m. Tuesday night, 7 p.m. Wednesday night, the Holy Oil Service, 7 p.m. Thursday night, the Crucifixion, 7 p.m. And Friday night, 7 p.m. for the Lamentation. Thursday morning, we're going to have a liturgy. It's called the Last Supper Liturgy at 10 o'clock in the morning. Friday morning, we're going to have the royal hours and bring the Lord Jesus from the cross and the vesper preparing for lamentation. We start the royal hours at 10 a.m. on Friday morning to 1 p.m. Saturday morning, we are going to have the holy fire liturgy. We start at 10 a.m. And Sunday, the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. We will start the resurrection. It's called the rush hour or the hajmi at 9:30 a.m. Be here at 9:30 a.m. so we can celebrate together the resurrection of Christ, so you could be a victorious person as your Savior is a victorious Lord. I look forward to see you this week. Don't skip days. Every day is very important. And I'm looking forward to see most of you this week. Amen. ابتهجي جدا يا صهيون. اهتفي يا بنت اورشليم. هو ذا ملك ياتي اليك هو عادل ومنصور ووديع. نعم الهنا عادل منصور ووديع. ان شاء الله نكون مثل الرب يسوع المسيح بحياتنا ونعتبره المخلص الاله الذي اتى لخلاص جنس البشر. ما ننسى الصلوات الأسبوع العظيم ابتداء من بكرة التنين صلاة الختن على الساعة 7 والثلاثة مساء صلاة الختن أيضا على الساعة 7. يوم الأربعاء صلاة الزيت. بطلب من الجميع أن يجيبوا زيت معهم للكنيسة ولألكم. يوم الأربعاء صلاة الزيت. يجيبوا زيت لألكم وللكنيسة. يوم الخميس الصبح عنا الداس الأسرار على 10 صباحا. الخميس مساء عندنا صلاة الصلبة على 7 مساء. يوم الجمعة صباحا عندنا صلاة الساعات إنزال المصلوب عن الصليب المقدس مع صلاة الغروب. وما ننسى الجمعة بالليل يكون عندنا صلاة الجنازة الرب يسوع المسيح المخلص. السبت بيكون عندنا سبت النور قداس سبت النور على 10 صباحا. ويوم الأحد احتفالنا بقيامة الرب يسوع المسيح من بين الأموات على الساعة 9:30 رح تكون الهجمة اللي اسمها قيامة الرب يسوع المسيح. مشان تجوا تاخدوا النور عينوا معنا وتحتفلوا بالأعياد وتحتفلوا بقيامة الرب يسوع المسيح. بعين الجميع بدخول الرب يسوع المسيح إلى مدينة أورشليم. إن شاء الله هذا النهار يكون مبارك ومقدس عليكم جميعا. وإن شاء الله اللي ما كان يجي على الكنيسة يبدأ يجي على الكنيسة كل يوم أحد. واللي ما تعود يتعود. لأن الصلاة فيها فائدة جدا. الصلاة هي منا عقاب للإنسان. الصلاة هي حوار مع الله. منجي على الكنيسة لكي نتحاور مع الله. واللي بيكون قاعد برا مش بيجي على الكنيسة هذا ما رايد الله ولا رايد الحوار مع ربنا. قد ما يكون منيح وقد ما يكون عمل بحياته مرة بالأسبوع منجي بالأيام العادية ومنصلي ومنشكر إلهنا على كل شيء لأنه عطينا أكثر ما منستاهل. صدقوني مرض صغير ما بينشاف بالعين سكر العالم سنة وشهرين والعالم ما زال مسكر والناس غرباني وخايفة. وتربنا بده يهز البشرية بهز البشرية بشغل صغير كتير. فكونوا مستعدين دائما للقاءكم مع المسيح لأنه مين منا بدنا هون ويشمس بهالدنيا مين مين شلش أكثر من 200 سنة أو من 150 سنة؟ مين؟ قولوا لي مين؟ تروح على قال له كيفك اليوم؟ شو أخبارك؟ ما فينا نعيش أكثر من 120 سنة. ما تتكابروا ولا تفكروا فيكم تعيشوا أكثر ما ربنا بيعطيكم عمر على هالدنيا. من محبتي لإلكم عم بقلكم خلوا الكنيسة جزء من حياتكم، لأنه الكنيسة هي اللي بترفعكم إلى الملكوت. الكنيسة هي بتفرجيكم وجه المسيح. الكنيسة هي اللي بتعطيكم الانتصار على الموت. الكنيسة هي اللي بتقلكم كلمة الخلاص. الكنيسة هي الملكوت، ملكوت الله الذي نراه الآن في أعيننا. أما الملكوت الحقيقي يا أيها الأحباء، لا يستطيع إنسان أن يراه إلا أن يجاهد جهادا حسنا ويربح الملكوت ويكون مع المسيح في كل وقت وفي كل ساعة. آمين. If you are going to receive communion today, make sure you receive communion. Make sure you open your mouth widely. I will put your spoon in the mouth. Close your mouth with your lips. Do not turn your back on the chalice. Make two steps back and go back to the from the chalice. Do not turn your back on the chalice. Go to the left and go sit down and go stand in your seat. Please remain standing the whole time. Do not sit during the communion. And don't leave till the service is over, because we have a big procession outside the church. But we're going to start from inside. So make sure you are inside the church. And let's remain quiet and silent. Because in church, we pray and praise and glorify God. Amen.